Hi, Christmas is coming soon and I thought it's a good time to make some decorations. This year I decided to prepare a PVC Christmas tree with blinking ping pong baubles. If you decide to build one yourself, I'll walk you through the whole process. Let's see a list of necessary tools and materials. We'll start with a sheet of low density PVC foam. It has a protective blue layer on one side. If you can't buy this material at your location, use foam board instead. Download the Christmas tree template from my website. You can find the link in the description below. Use a glue stick for paper to glue the template to the PVC sheet. Let the glue dry for a couple of minutes. If you're using foam board, remove the paper first. Spraying the board with isopropyl alcohol makes it really easy. Now it's time to cut the shape with an X-Acto knife. We need a very sharp tool, so it's a good idea to use a new blade. Please, be very careful and don't cut yourself. Cut off the base for the Christmas tree first. Lead the blade along the lines and don't apply too much pressure with the first cut. Go through the same lines a few times, pressing more with each cut. You don't have to be super precise because we will sand the edges later on. Corners are the most difficult part, so take your time. Mark the holes for LEDs before you peel off the paper template. All the glue should stay on paper and the board should be nice and clean. Take 150 grit sandpaper or finer and sand all the edges. Drill the holes and clean the rough edges with your X-Acto knife. Now it's time to paint the tree on both sides, including the edge. I'm using an acrylic paint, but you can spray paint it if you have a can of green paint lying around. Push the LEDs through the holes and hot glue them in place. The LEDs should stick out quite a bit. I didn't have a green wire, so I peeled off some insulation from an Ethernet cable and used the green pair of wires for this project. Strip off insulation on one end of each wire. You need 10 wires for the positive rail and another 10 for ground. The longer lead is positive and the shorter one is ground. We want to wire the LEDs in parallel by connecting all positive leads using the green wires and all ground leads with the white-green wires. solder all the green wires and bend the leads as you need to avoid short circuits. The positive rail is done, so it's time to do the same with the ground rail. After all the LEDs are wired, it's a good idea to check continuity with the multimeter. You can also check if there is no short circuit. If everything is wired correctly, you can use hot glue to hold all the wires in place and seal the joints. At this point, I decided to use my bench power supply to check if all the LEDs work. I set voltage to around 3 volts and voila, all LEDs are blinking like crazy. Now we know the rig is working, so we can solder a battery holder. Another test with batteries, and another success. You can finish at this point if you're happy with the result. I went a bit further and used ping pong balls as baubles. Most ping pong balls have texts and logos printed on them. You can get rid of this by using very fine sandpaper. Now the ball looks so much better. Since we used 10 LEDs, you need 10 blank ping pong balls. You know what to do, so start sanding. We want to drill a single hole in each ball. The size of the hole should be exactly the same as your LED's diameter. Apply some hot glue around the hole and press the ball to our tree, so the LED goes into the hole. Wait a few seconds until the glue dries. Do the same with the rest of the balls. We're done. So let's see how the Christmas tree looks like in the dark. Thank you for following this tutorial. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments section. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Share it with your friends or consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time.